So I'm driving back from caffeine and carburetors in New Canaan, Connecticut, something that four times a year, car nuts throughout the New York area all converge into downtown New Canaan, Connecticut, and everything from $4 million antique Ferraris to your 60s era Land Cruisers to your 1980s 308 Ferraris and your BMWs and your Lamborghinis and everything you can imagine is there. Today I saw a 1935 Auburn with the most gorgeous body I've ever seen. I saw a McLaren P1 and the new Porsche 918, and I mean, it's just awesome. And everybody there is there to talk and to have a good time. Absolutely awesome. I gotta say though, after getting up at 6 a.m. to go to this thing, I'm pretty worn out now. So anyway, I wanted to talk a little bit about, I guess, the experience driving there, and also some top fives. The top five reasons why I love my M5. And I wanted to be tight about it because I tend to jump around a little bit when I'm talking about how exciting these cars are and how they make me feel. So I'm going to try to be succinct about it. Alright, so five things, right? Five things I love about this car. One, the engine. The 507 horsepower 5-liter V10 that redlines at 8,250 RPM. They just don't make them like that anymore. At the show today, Caffeine and Carburetors, a lot of people came up to me and were basically saying the same thing that I'm saying right here. The last great was powerful, naturally aspirated engine that BMW will ever produce. So, for what that's worth, awesome, awesome, awesome engine. Just has endless, endless thrust. It will never run out of breath. Though it will run out of gas. Number two, the M button. This little button here on the steering wheel. Normally, when you start the engine up, it has a more sedate 400 horsepower. And that's perfectly sufficient for most people's needs. You don't really need to go more than, you don't need more than 400 horsepower. You don't need 300 horsepower, but 400, it's a nice, solid, powerful feel to it. Maybe it gets a little bit better gas mileage, but then you press the M button and it becomes a beast. Completely changes personalities, the Jekyll and Hyde, absolutely the case. And that extra 107 horsepower makes a big difference. And I can say. Number three, the way the engine cracks when I shift gears. The way it seems angry with me when I'm driving slowly is it wants to eat up the tarmac in front of me. Number four, the way the car stays flat in corners. This car weighs 2 tons. There are car seats in the back. This is my family car. I call it the ultimate family hauler. But it stays flat. It's amazing how well this car handles. It should not handle this well. And I get into, you know, regular cars, and I'm just astonished at the difference. Reason number five. Well, I guess I kind of already explained some of it, is that it's a family car. I can take all my family, or my two daughters and my wife, and all of their stuff in comfort. There's a bump and stereo in the back. The kids love the stereo. They're doing their thing. They're happy. My wife is reading a book in the passenger seat. Meanwhile, I'm driving this thing. So everybody's happy. When we're in the M3, not so much the case. So it's great to be able to have family sedan that I can enjoy and still have my family in the car with me. The next area I wanted to hit was the biggest surprises I've experienced having this car. The reason number one, or the biggest surprise, is the fuel economy. I burned through a quarter of a tank of gas. On the highway, this car will get about 20 miles per gallon, especially if you drive it conservatively, you don't speed too much, you don't use the throttle too much. But when driving in town, and granted, I use the engine, I try to have a good time, I accelerate pretty quickly. But I just don't sustain that speed because of law enforcement, you know, responsibility issues and things like that. Every time I filled up the tank, you know, in the last few months, I've been tracking it, and it's good when I get 11 miles per gallon. And I look at the average here, it says 11.8, and the time that I've owned the car, 11.8. If I do more highway driving, it'll end up being about 13.5. But certainly, lousy fuel economy. When BMW sought out to make this the most efficient engine they could, they were talking about fuel economy. They were talking about extracting as much power out of that 5-liter V10 as they possibly could. They did a marvelous job at that. But nevertheless, I just can't believe how much gas this thing drinks. And oil, too. And the BMW oil, that Castrol, ain't cheap. The other surprise, surprise number two, is that you do have to work it hard to get the performance out of it. But when you do, it's amazing. You know, it makes me giggle like a little girl. I'm just having such a great time. But you really have to know the car, and you have to know how to push it. And once you master the car, there's just not a better feeling in the world. Reason number three. About your business, the drudgery of driving sensibly with your family in the back, you can really enjoy yourself. It's really satisfying to know that even if you're not able to tap into that engine all the time, you can still enjoy yourself. You can still have the satisfaction of having a powerful engine. You can hear the wail of the engine. It's a quiet, sensible rumble, so that you're not a car enthusiast, you're not going to really be aware of what it is. And maybe it sounds a little bit meaner and a little bit deeper than what you would expect in a sensible German sedan. Most people just don't know what it is. And that's part of what I like about it. It's a sleeper car. Let's see, number four. When you're in a hurry, there isn't a better car to be in. There have been a few occasions, and there aren't that many of them, but when I was with my family and we needed to get somewhere immediately, this is the car to be in. It changes personalities. It's normally a sensible, you know, Dr. Jekyll. When you press that in button and you challenge the car, it bends the laws of physics. You just can't believe that it can do what it can do. And you know, you're just able to go twice as fast, twice as far, everything so much more than what you expect any car to be able to do. It just shocks you how capable this car is. And then number five, this may be the biggest surprise, but it's been a delightful surprise. Nobody knows what it is. Yes, I was just at Caffeine and Carburetors, where everybody knew what the car was, and they were all paying respect to it. But most people, no idea what it is. And so, the only people who seem to be aware of what it is are, you know, other car enthusiasts. So I have these incredibly satisfying conversations. People will approach me in a parking lot, and we'll talk for 10 minutes and have just a grand old time talking about it. But then there are the douchebags, the people that make me really nervous. And my kids are in the back seat, and they're coming up, and they're acting in a way that makes me just a little bit nervous. But it's nice, you know. I was parked next to a red Ferrari at the Caffeine and Carburetors, and you know, how do you drive that thing without attracting a ton of attention? I don't want to attract attention. I just want to have a car that makes me feel good when I'm driving it. five biggest surprises and my five biggest loves of this car. It's great.